It is National Nurses Day, and local businesses are showing their appreciation. Heather Lake live in Bankers Hill with how locals are taking part. Morning, Heather.
Oh, good morning. Yeah, this is so awesome. Putting a smile on all of our nurses' faces. We cannot say it enough. Thank you to our nurses and all of our medical professionals out there. It's been quite a year for all of us, right? But especially people who haven't gotten a vacation, who have been working around the clock. So this is it. We've got a lineup here, and it's a drive-through so that you can get all kinds of treats, goodies, snacks, gift cards. St. Paul Senior Services putting this all on. They've got more than 300 nurses that work on staff, and they've opened this up to all area nurses to come on through on National Nurses Day, get free coffee from Nostalgia Coffee, grab a free personalized donut from the donut bar in San Diego. People, the community are really coming together to just be out here and put a smile on their faces, whether you're coming off of your shift or going to your shift. This is all open until 9 o'clock today, so you got a half an hour, and we've been kind of chatting and saying hi. I've been giving a lot of air fives to my nurses today, right? I got to tell you, this is one of those days where you're just like, thank you, thank you, thank you. We've all been through it, whether we had a family member, a friend, or whatever, and I just wonder how you guys are continuing on every day, showing up. What is it that keeps you going?
What keeps us going is working with each other. We have great nurses and a great team here at St. Paul's, and even though we've been really stressed, we've enjoyed having each other to work with.
Yeah, and I've been talking to a lot of the nurses this morning, and they're saying there's just something right now, too. The excitement is brewing. The light is at the end of the tunnel, and for all of you, you're starting to even feel like yourselves are a little more protected going into work every day.
Absolutely. All of our residents at the St. Paul's Villa are vaccinated, and most of our staff, we're probably close to 90% of the staff being vaccinated. So it does feel a lot safer, and we're just happy we're able to get vaccinated and keep going.
What was it like for you when you're working with the seniors and your first seniors finally got to give a hug again to their grandchild or their daughter or son? What was that like?
It was tearing, because yeah, you could just, there was anticipation, the seniors knowing, you know, I'm not going to be able to see my family members, but when they were able to do it, it was just amazing to watch, just yeah, very refreshing and inspiring. Just yeah, you could see the light at the end of the tunnel.
Yeah, and I know you're one of the supervisors, so you've seen a lot of these stories. Your donut's waiting for you, by the way, and I don't want you to be late to work, because that's what your manager's over there, and he said, hey, she's about to be late to work. We'll let you go on through. Thank you so much for chatting with us, and thank you. I can't say it enough this morning. So I also wanted to talk about, not only are they doing this, a huge shout out to our nurses and a huge shout out to the students and the people who are going into the nursing field during all of this and are still inspired to keep on going. Corey, you're someone who's hiring right now, and you said, well, there's more than 300 nurses on staff. You're still looking for more, even if you're going into your very first job.
Yeah, we have over 650 employees throughout St. Paul's platforms, and well over 300 of those are direct caregivers. Caregivers, nurses, CNAs, LVNs, all the way up to nurse practitioners. And yeah, we're hiring at all levels of nursing, all levels in food and beverage. We have job openings all over the county, so absolutely.
Well, I have to tell you, from someone who's been covering stories since the beginning of this pandemic, you know, I was someone who was with a bunch of kids making cards at the very beginning of this for seniors at a lot of these senior centers, including your own, and now we're to this place where they're vaccinated and able to see family members. It's been such a full circle, and I know sometimes we all wake up in the morning and we go, oh, we're still in this, but we really have come such a long way.
We have come a long way. We've been very lucky here, because we are a senior center, that we were amongst the first to get vaccinated. Our seniors were over 97% vaccinated. Over 92% of our employees have received their first shot, and I believe 86% are fully vaccinated. So we're really proud of that. We are one of the first to get vaccinated, and we're really proud of our high vaccination rates too.
Yeah, you guys have had quite the organization, and obviously, as we can see this morning, organizing to say thank you. And
lots of coffee, lots of donuts. We're glad to be here.
Coffee will get us far in this world, I will tell you that. You know what? This is a morning to say thank you, and also a morning of hope, as we start to see all the smiles on these nurses' faces, as we have come quite a long way. I remember celebrating National Nurses Day last year, which was very different from this year. So something to say thank you from all these people who have working around the clock. And Raul, as many of us in our own studio are looking for a vacation, these nurses are definitely hoping for that as well before the end of this year. I've talked to so many of them, and they're like, oh, if I could just get to Hawaii finally, it'll feel so good. And so they're finally asking for those days off and hoping for that vacation with the waves, you know, and just being able to relax finally. We're seeing the light at the end of that tunnel, and we can't say thank you enough to these nurses.
I think they've earned it, and I think they deserve it a lot more than we do, that's for sure. Heather, thank you, and thank you, nurses.